Today we are working with variables. And in math, we have two types of variables. We have an independent variable and a dependent variable. Now, if we take a look at our variables on a coordinate plane, our independent variable is always on our x-axis, and our dependent variable is always on our y-axis. Now, the independent variable is what we can control, and that independent variable has a direct effect on the dependent variable. Now, in math, we have to be able to identify which variable is our independent variable and which variable is our dependent variable, because that's going to help us graph these variables. So, let's take a look at this problem. The amount of money, called M, earned if X raffle tickets are sold. So I want you to think, what do we have more control over? Do we have more control over the raffle tickets, or do we have more control over the money? And what usually helps is think, what is going to affect the other? Well, the number of raffle tickets directly affects the amount of money that we make. So when we are identifying our independent variable, the raffle tickets, X, is what we can control, and it directly affects how much money M that we will earn. Therefore, M is our dependent variable. Now let's look at another one. The number of hours H worked and the amount of money M earned. Okay, the number of hours directly affects how much money is earned. Therefore, our hours H has to be our independent variable, and that's affecting directly our dependent variable of M. Let's look at this final one. The number of shelves S in a bookcase and the number of books B the bookcase can hold. Well, if I have one shelf, it can hold a certain number of books, but if I add a second shelf, I can get more books. Therefore, it's the shelves that are directly affecting the number of books we can store on it. Therefore, our independent variable would be S, the shelves, and our dependent variable would be B, the number of books stored. So, if you can always think of how one variable is affecting the other variable, that helps us identify our independent and dependent variable. So that's about it for us today. Now it's your turn.